Hello everyone, myself Sagar Ramesh Kote, working as Assistant Professor, Department of Physics, JMD College, Sinnar, Nasik. Now, last lecture, we will discuss characteristics of laser, that is directionality, monochromaticity, coherence, intensity. Now, in this lecture, we will discuss example. First example, fluorescent tube light emit visible light of wavelength in the range of 4000 angstrom to the 7000 angstrom with an average wavelength of 5000 angstrom. Calculate the coherence length and coherence time. Now in this numerical given, lambda is equal to 5000 angstrom, that is wavelength range is delta lambda 4000 to 7000. We will calculate L coherence and TC, that is coherence time. Formula: the coherence length is given by L coherence is equal to lambda square upon 2 into delta lambda. Now put this value, 5000 square upon 2 into 7000 minus 4000, that is L coherence is equal to 4166.67, is nearly about equal to 4167 angstrom. Now the coherence time is TC is equal to L coherence upon C, that is value 4167 into 10 raised to minus 10 upon 3 into 10 raised to 8. Now calculating, the value will be the 1389 into 10 raised to minus 18 sec. Now next example, light from the sodium lamp, which is the traditional monochromatic source, have coherence length about 0.3 micrometer and the bandwidth is about 6 angstrom. Calculate the wavelength of sodium lamp. Now given this numerical, bandwidth, that is delta lambda is equal to 6 angstrom, that is 6 into 10 raised to minus 10 meter. L coherence is equal to 0.3, that is 0.3 into 10 raised to minus 3. We will calculate lambda. Formula: the coherence length is L coherence is equal to lambda square upon 2 into delta lambda. Now in this numerical, the value of L coherence delta lambda, we will calculate lambda. That is, rearrange this equation in lambda square. Lambda square is equal to L coherence into delta lambda into 2. Put this value, lambda square is equal to 2 into 6 into 10 raised to minus 10 into 0.3 into 10 raised to 3. Now solving this, we will get the value of lambda square is 0.36 into 10 raised to 12. Now this will be the value of lambda square. Now we will calculate the value of lambda. Now under root of this value, that is 0.36 into 10 raised to 12, we will the value of lambda. Now the value of lambda is 0.6 into 10 raised to 6, that is equal to 6000 into 10 raised to minus 10 meter, that is 6000 angstrom. Now third example, light from a helium neon laser, which is traditional monochromatic source, has a coherence length about 100 meter and wavelength 6328 angstrom. Calculate the bandwidth of the helium neon laser. Given, L coherence is equal to 100 meter, that is 100 into 10 raised to minus 10 angstrom. Lambda is equal to 6328 angstrom, that is 6328 into 10 raised to minus 10 meter. Calculate bandwidth, that is delta lambda. Formula: the coherence length is L coherence is equal to lambda square upon 2 into delta lambda. Now arrange the equation in bandwidth, that is delta lambda. Delta lambda is equal to lambda square upon 2 L coherence. Put this value, delta lambda is equal to 6328 into 10 raised to 10 bracket square upon 2 into 10 100 into 10 raised to minus 10. Now solving this equation, we will get the value of delta lambda is 2 into 10 raised to minus 5 angstrom. Now next example, calculating intensity of laser beam having emissive power 1 micro millivolt and bandwidth is 6328 into 10 raised to minus 10 meter. An intensity of UV laser beam having emissive power 5 microwatt and the wavelength 6943 into 10 raised to minus 10 meter. Solution: The intensity of laser beam is I is equal to 10 square upon lambda square into P. First, for the helium laser beam, lambda is equal to 6328 into 10 raised to minus 10 meter, and P will be the 1, that is 1 into 10 raised to minus 3 watt. I is equal to 100 into 10 raised to minus 3 upon 6328 into 10 raised to minus 10 square, that is I is equal to 2.5 into 10 raised to 11 watt per meter square. Now second, for ruby laser, lambda is equal to 6943 into 10 raised to minus 10 meter, at P will be the 5, that is 5 into 10 raised to minus 3. Put this value in this equation. I is equal to 100 into 5 into 10 raised to minus 3 upon 6943 upon into 10 raised to minus 10 bracket square. The value of I will be the 10.37 into 10 raised to 11 watt per meter square. Now this will be the example of module 5. Thank you so much.